Video. In this video, I'll be reacting to one of the early uploads from the YouTube channel The Game Theorist. This video came out in 2015, so I think it's around 6 years ago. I hope that you like it. Let's start.
Racism? Cops? GTA? Woohoo! Boy, forget putting a joke here, I need a flame shield. Hello, Internet! Welcome to Game Theory!
Hello! Quick reminder, racism against anybody, right, is bad. You know, you are human, I'm human. My thought is, everybody is the same. Don't show racism. If you are black, if you are Asian, if you are white, I don't care. We are all human beings, correct? So yeah, racism is bad. Having said that, let's continue with the video.
The only show that's still happy to go bowling with Cousin Roman whenever he wants.
Nico, it's Roman. Let's go bowling.
Now, if there's one thing we love here on Game Theory, it's polarizing controversy. Well, that, Diet Coke, bad puns, and bad-mouthing Nintendo's most beloved characters. But polarizing controversy is definitely somewhere in the top five. Maybe like number four, just below bad puns, but just above bad-mouthing Nintendo characters. No, definitely above bad puns. So polarizing controversy, solid number three. And there is no single franchise more densely packed with controversy than Grand Theft Auto. Did you ever wonder why Game Theory is abbreviated GT? Oh, you thought it was from the words Game Theory. Yeah, that would make sense. But seriously, from the very beginning, this series has been rocking a serious case of public outcry. Grand Theft Auto 1 raised an uproar for its violence, GTA 3 banned in Australia, and San Andreas, which introduced the world to awkward, fully clothed polygon sex, years before Ride to Hell Retribution. Oh, but it should be mentioned that that hot coffee mod helped propel the game to be the best-selling PS2 game of all time.
Of all time. Wow.
Then there was GTA 4, which took a little-known lawyer by the name of Jack Thompson and turned him into a one-man crusader against gaming violence, putting his name on national news and on gamers' hit lists. In GTA 4, you assassinate a lawyer named Tom Goldberg, whose in-game quote is, well, I'll let him speak for himself.
Guns don't kill people, video games do.
Coincidence? I think not.
No. No. You...
It's like these games are being controversial just to get some free PR. And now we have Grand Theft Auto 5, which to date has earned over $2 billion. It also happened to be the fastest entertainment product ever to reach $1 billion, beating out everything from Call of Duty to the Avengers, and easily is the best-selling game in the franchise, crushing the sales of all other titles. Oh, and it's also probably the most controversial. It seems like everyone's been trying to get this game pulled off shelves for its depiction of torture, for allegedly stealing rapper Daz Dillinger's music, for copying Lindsay Lohan's likeness, and for the kid in the UK who called 911 pretending to be hurt after he got shot in the game. Smooth move, X-Lax. But you know what, Internet? This is all beside the point because I'm not here for any of these. No, loyal theorists, I've got bigger fish to fry. GTA 5 takes place in Los Santos, an analog for Los Angeles, and it's one of the biggest, most realistic depictions of a real city in a virtual world in the history of... ever. I mean, seriously, you lose GPS signal when you go through a tunnel, car engines have a cooldown tink 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 sound, even flip-flops flop when you flip them. Sure, traffic laws may be slightly more lenient and the cops slightly more aggressive. Okay, a lot more aggressive, but you gotta hand it to Rockstar. They put an unbelievable amount of detail into this game. So it begs the question, did they go so far as to program the cops to racially profile the game's characters? Oh, that came out of left field.
Oh, that came up wrong. That came up wrong. We should never, 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 never be biased against one another due to race. You know, we are all human beings. I see each other as the human race. Understand? So yeah, don't show biasness against each other. We're all human. So, no racism. Honestly speaking, just no racism. If you want to show racism, honestly don't know who. Who would do that? Why would you do that? Anyways, I will see each other as human beings. Yeah. Anyways, let's continue. One more time, racism is bad. Continue.
I feel like I just dropped a bomb in the middle of this video, but I'm not the one who started asking. A quick Google search reveals that some gamers seem to think that this might be the case. Franklin, one of the three characters you play in the game, is black, and hails from the Los Santos version of South Central LA, a poorer part of the city known for its violence and gangs. Well, the problem of racially aware cops started, bizarrely enough, when a video came out showing the cops freaking out and wasting Franklin after he simply walked up to him and talked for a moment. Hey there, officer! Bam, you're dead. It's an extreme reaction. So I ask the question, when a franchise that thrives on controversy partners with a dev team that goes to painstaking lengths to make things like stubble grow on your clean-shaven chin just to make the game more realistic, is them adding racial bias into its core AI code really so hard to believe? I mean, let's put this into a historical context. Los Santos is meant to be LA, right? Well, think about it. Accusations of police racism and brutality in Los Angeles started hitting national news back in 1990. When Rodney King and two other passengers were beaten by four officers after a high-speed DUI car chase. When a jury found three out of the four officers innocent, Los Angeles was plunged into 6 days of street riots. Since then, racial profiling has been a hot topic in the area. According to a study done by Yale analyzing the LAPD's records, black people were twice as likely to be stopped, twice as likely to be cited, and 8 times as likely to be arrested as a white person. And if you're thinking that this might have to do with there being more crimes occurring in traditionally black neighborhoods, think again. The study normalized for crime rates, and the results still stood. It also discounted the variable of more officers being deployed in those sections of town. The study also found that rates of citation were lower for black citizens, meaning that more people were getting pulled over for no reason that would prompt a ticket or arrest. The study posits that they were being pulled over solely for the color of their skin. So that's the analysis of one study looking at data from the LAPD. Is there the need for more studies? Absolutely. Absolutely. Reliable data tracking these issues is actually surprisingly limited. But if Rockstar wanted to prompt controversy in this game, there's definitely some real-life ties to back all this up. Well, that's impossible, MatPat, you say, in a voice that oddly resembles my own. Rockstar themselves have already denied that such a mechanic exists, so why trust their words when you can trust something much harder to fake? Numbers, data. This week, we're throwing away the anecdotal evidence and getting results of our own the good old-fashioned way, conducting our own in-game controlled experiment. Unlike other games in the main series, GTA 5 has three simultaneous protagonists. One of them is Franklin, whom we've already met, and the others are Trevor, a psychotic white trash drug dealer, and Michael, a rich white retired thief trying to adjust to boring old parenthood. Because they so perfectly represent three separate demographics, we decided to not only run tests with Franklin, but also Trevor and Michael. The idea was to dress them all in neutral clothes, then take them around to three separate police stations in three different socioeconomic climates. Of the 6 or 7 police stations we were thinking about including, the ones that would most reliably spawn static police officers in any measurable capacity were the bougie Vinewood Station, representative of real-world Hollywood, the rural, less affluent Paleto Bay Station, reminiscent of smaller North California bay towns like Monterey, and the beaten-up rundown South Los Santos Station, Franklin's hometown meant to simulate South Central Hollywood, places like the infamous Compton. In the interest of accuracy, we repeated each test with each of the three characters 5 times. And we tried to do it in as similar of a situation as we could consistently recreate in a system so dependent on spawning mechanics. Time of day was probably our biggest variable since it was so difficult to control for in this experiment. Then, in addition to the original test, we also did a version using one of the game's spawnable cheat code cards. The Rapid GT. Get it? GT? For Grand Theft? Oh, I could have said for game theory! Damn it, there it goes again.
And- ah!
Anyway, in this case, rather than talking to the police officers, we'd pull up to them in our cars and honk at them once before driving away. Again, 5 times per station, in all 3 police stations, for all 3 characters. Finally, we needed a control group.
Just saying, there's a lot of data and results. Just saying.
To compare against. This was meant to prove that the police are being provoked purely by your interaction with them in that moment and not due to some other previous crime you might have committed earlier. So we repeated each experiment again, 5 times each with all 3 characters in all 3 locations, but rather than interact with them, we just walk past them holding a gun. And as we hoped, this garnered no response from anyone in any group.
My gosh, that is even more data and more results here.
Since, of course, nothing at all would be alarming about a guy just walking down the street brandishing a handgun in full view. There's nothing concerning about that. But anyway, it proved that we were back to a neutral state, and thus we had our control. Finally, we needed a system to score the results. So for each test, if there was no response from the officers, it was worth 0 points. An aggressive but non-violent response was worth 1 point, and a full-on arrest or murder with our star counter going up was worth 2 points. Results were tallied and recorded on video, and after about 20 hours of battling the random spawning, we finally had our results.
Wow, it's about 20 hours here. It's like a long, 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 long day for you guys. Thank you so much for this experiment. It really helps us as a humankind to further improve.
Here's what we found. Let's start with Vinewood, the equivalent of Hollywood in Los Santos. This is where the rich hobnob and pay thousands of dollars for each square foot of space. And you know what? Just as Rockstar claimed, everyone was treated basically the same. When driving past honking at the police, none of the 3 characters elicited any sort of response across all 15 trials. And when we moved on to the second test, having each character go up and speak with the police, every single time the interaction resulted in some level of aggression. Michael and Franklin both received 3 aggressive responses and 2 responses with full-on force, and Trevor had 4 general aggressive responses and only 1 with force. Chalk that minor difference up to randomness, or the fact that a drugged out white dude on the street in the daytime is a common sight in Central Hollywood, and honestly, after round 1, everything is looking pretty darn fair. 0 responses in the car, 5 responses of fairly similar aggression across all 3 characters, seems pretty colorblind. Good thing there wasn't a character who dressed like an unlicensed version of Spider-Man, then charged people to take pictures with him, then we would see some police hostility. Anyway.
Or maybe it's just that your experiment, your results were not, were not enough. Maybe like 100 times, 1000 times, but you can't blame on them because 20 hours is already a lot. You can't just like make them spend one entire month or one entire year trying to make this experiment, right?
It was time to move north to Paleto Bay, a small rural town on the coast. Here, if we were looking to prove police bias against the Black Franklin, we found the exact opposite. Franklin was stopped the least. In the car, he was ignored every time, and talking to the cops only prompted 3 responses, one of which was violent. Michael also got away scot-free in the car, but was harassed 4 times for talking to the cops, with 2 interactions turning violent. But Trevor here was the oddball, who was far and away harassed the most. Stopped all 5 times for talking to the cops, with things turning violent twice. Then, in the car, he received a response twice. All of a sudden, the point difference here is pretty pronounced, with Franklin sporting 4 points, Michael with 6, and Trevor with 9. It's certainly a pronounced spread for something that we've tried to control for, so why would we possibly see a reverse bias here? Well, it correlates with data from the real-life US Census for areas like this. It may be that Trevor is getting hassled the most because a poor-looking white guy is the most common criminal archetype in the predominantly white middle-class area of Paleto Bay. Franklin, meanwhile, gets the least attention because he's in an area where, according to the US Census data, the Black population is typically low, and the stereotype of a scary Black man is much less likely to be culturally reinforced. But then again, each character is only 2 or 3 points apart, so it could be chalked up to just an odd quirk in the random number generators. Which means we can't put a solid conclusion on the books yet until we go to our third location, South Los Santos, described by the game as the economically depressed, predominantly African-American area of the city, stigmatized in the media as a hotbed for drugs, crime, and gangs. If there's going to be police bias against the Black character in the game, it would happen here. And you know what? it did. And it would be difficult to chalk this difference up to random number generation. Let's look at the data. When driving around and honking in South Los Santos, Rich White Michael and Crazy White Trevor both prompted only one response, and it was nonviolent. Franklin, meanwhile, was harassed 4 times, and of those instances, 1 was violent. That's a huge difference. Off the car trial alone, Michael and Trevor are sporting 1 point, and Franklin is already at 5. So then we went on to look at the characters talking to the cops. Rich White Michael was bothered 2 times, both times a nonviolent response. By contrast, Franklin was harassed all 5 times, 2 of which turned violent. In fact, looking at the point breakdown of all the characters across all the trials in South Los Santos, Michael had only 3 points of police attention. Trevor had 8, and Franklin had 12. In other words, this breaks down exactly as we would expect. The poorer characters were seen as more threatening in a lower income area, while Rich Whitey skated by unnoticed. The point is, despite what Rockstar says, the data here seems to indicate a socioeconomic relationship between local police of these various cities and the citizens they're meant to protect that fairly accurately relates to the real-world equivalents. So does this mean that it's all some big conspiracy? That Rockstar is lying about their own game to hide their racist agenda? Absolutely not. In fact, it's extremely possible that our own prejudices about race affected the test in some way, or the variables we couldn't control for actually affected the results a lot more than we expected. Or maybe the results are indeed random, and I just got lucky, and Franklin got unlucky. The sad truth of this video, though, is that people having a knee-jerk reaction, calling cops are racist at the first sight of a police officer's response to a black character, that's the alarming thing here. Police brutality, police racism. Look at the data and judge for yourself, but regardless of what you believe is or isn't happening here, these are concepts that are ingrained in our social consciousness, and that is the truly tragic thing. There just shouldn't be a reason to fear people whose job description is to protect and serve.
I only listen to white rappers.
I think that's a good idea.
I only listen to white rappers.
To protect and serve, you're supposed to protect all of us. And serve all of us. Not just a selective group.
Dialogue in this game is wait, was that racist? But hey, that's just a theory.
Drone Death Auto, teaching to drone stars since
1997. A game theory! Thanks for watching! Once again, I'd like to thank Squarespace.com for helping to make this video possible. It's through the support of sponsors, and through your support of those sponsors, that we're able to do back-to-back game theories like we were able to do this week, and do ones that take even more time to research than they already do. Running controlled experiments in randomized game environments is a really tough thing. So thanks to your support and the advertisers, I'm able to work with fantastic people like Ronnie, Ryder, First, and Alex, as we all work our buns off to make sure that you guys get your regular dose of game theorizing. So that being said, let me tell you about Squarespace. If you have ever wanted to build your own website, consider Squarespace.com. They have the tools to make it look both beautiful and functional. The system's completely integrated with Google Apps, Getty Images, and every website comes with a free online store. There's also 24/7 live chat and email support if you need help setting it up. But most importantly, their system allows your website to translate to any device. It looks great on computer, but then it can transition to a mobile website or even for your tablet. And honestly, it's a small price to pay for a beautiful, fully functional website. Squarespace only costs $8. And you get a free domain name if you buy Squarespace for the year, and you can get 10% off by using our code GAMETHEORISTS. So go into the URL bar and type squarespace.com/GAMETHEORISTS, click the annotation right here, or click the link in the description and start building your own site today. And you know what? If you do, hit me up on Twitter at MattPatGT to show me what you've created. I'd love to check it out. It's always really awesome seeing the cool stuff that you guys are up to, so I appreciate you sharing it with me. It's a good mutual relationship, I feel like. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm in the middle of researching another video that was kind of inspired by this one, but you'll just have to wait till next time to see what it is.
Let me say it one more time. We are all human beings. Biasness is bad. We should not, we must not have biasness against each other. Understand? Man. We are all human beings. We must not have biasness against each other. That we must not have racism against each other. Alright, thank you so much for watching this video. If you do like this video, please consider to like, share and subscribe to my channel and comment down below if you have anything to share with us. Yeah. This video came out from the YouTube channel The Game Theorist. If you do like this video, please consider showing support to their channel. And as always, that's just a theory. A game theory. Thanks for watching.